In this video, I am going to show you how to create a simple scale by connecting a 4-wire load cell like this to the HX711 amplifier module and then read the weight values with an Arduino. They come with different weight ratings, from 1 kilogram to a couple of 100 kilograms, and they usually look like a metal block with some holes drilled into it. Here I have a 20 kilogram load cell and a 200 kilogram load cell. For this tutorial, I am going to use the 20 kilogram module. This video is a follow-up to my previous tutorial about the 50 kilogram bathroom scale load cells with 3 wires. The main difference between those two load cells is that the 4-wire one has a full Wheatstone bridge embedded into it. The 3-wire 50 kilogram bathroom scale modules are only half bridges. If you have those, then please follow my other tutorial that is specifically about them. There are 4 special kinds of resistors called strain gauges glued onto the load cell. When you apply force to the metal block, 2 of the strain gauges will compress and the other 2 will stretch. Together, those resistors will form a Wheatstone bridge where the compression and tension resistor pairs are opposing each other. Now we can let the current flow through the Wheatstone bridge from top to bottom. We can measure the voltage change between the side corners. When there is some weight placed onto the load cell, the resistors will change their values in opposite directions. This resistance drift creates a voltage difference that we can measure. Since the voltage difference is tiny, we need the HX711 amplifier module to make it readable for Arduino. This load cell is a straight metal block. We need to build a frame around it so that force coming from the top will deform the middle part. You could screw it between 2 wooden planks, just make sure you put some spacers between the load cell and the board. Otherwise, there is no room for deformation. Instead of wooden planks, I have 3D printed those 2 parts. This is the top plate and the other one is the base frame. I am crimping the 2 pawn connectors to the end of the 4 wires. It makes it much easier to do experiments. Spread the wire threads a little to make a better connection. Now I can plug and unplug the cables without having to resolder every time. I really recommend you to buy a crimping tool. Both male and female pin connectors and different size housings. I use them with almost every project. Before connecting it to the amplifier, we should verify the wires. You most likely have the same wire colors connected the same way, but I think it is still a good idea to check. Trust but verify. The opposing corners of the Wheatstone bridge have higher resistance. In my case, black and red have around 1 kilo ohm, and green and white have about 1 kilo ohm of resistance. If I measure any other combination, then I get from 750 to 850 ohms. So we have two pairs, black-red and white-green. One of them will connect to the E plus and E minus power outputs of the HX711 module, and the other pair is for measurement and goes to the A plus and A minus inputs of the amplifier module. It doesn't really matter which is power and which is measurement, but to follow common convention, I am going to choose the black and red to be power. So the red wire goes to the E plus and the black wire goes to the E minus. White will go to the A minus and green will go to the A plus. Again, it doesn't actually matter. You may also connect the green to A minus and the white to A plus. It just inverts the calibration constant in the software. On the Arduino side, connect the VCC pin to the Arduino 5V pin and GND to Arduino ground. Connect the amplifier's data pin to Arduino digital input pin 4 and clock to pin 5. Now download the HX711 ADC library. The link is in the description box. Copy it to the Arduino libraries folder. Now you can open file, examples, HX711 ADC calibration. If you used pins 4 and 5, you could load the example to your Arduino without any modifications. Let's open Arduino terminal. It's crucial to select the correct baud rate. It is 57.6 kilobits per second for this example. If you don't do this, you will only see garbage in the terminal window. First, it asks to enter the letter T to set the current level to 0. So T and enter. It asks to place a known weight onto the scale. I'll weigh this glass of water on a kitchen scale. It asks if the calibration value should be saved to the EEPROM. Yes. You probably don't want to recalibrate after every startup. A little announcement before we continue. If you find this video useful and you want to see more tutorials like this, then please hit the subscribe button. Back to the video. Now that the calibration parameter is saved to the EEPROM, we can open the read1x load cell example to avoid the need to recalibrate every time. Uncomment the row that reads the calibration parameter from the EEPROM. Let's try to weigh something else. We'll be right back. In this tutorial, I only focused on the load cell and the HX711 amplifier module. If you want, you can also connect a screen to the Arduino and build a fully functional scale. In this case, I am reusing an old project I did about 3 years ago. It's a PCB that connects the 1.8-inch screen to an Arduino Nano. You can do the same stuff on a breadboard. Thank you for watching.